Since the release of 13th Gen and Ryzen 7000, both Intel and AMD have been locked in a fierce battle for the hearts and wallets of PC enthusiasts. Even more so now with the release of new Ryzen 7000 X3D chips. But with so many CPUs to choose from, how do you know which one is right for you? There are a whopping 23 current 13th generation CPUs, along with 10 Ryzen 7000 CPUs, not to mention the 25 12th generation CPUs, not even including Ryzen 5000 or 3000 CPUs. That's enough to make your head spin faster than a CPU fan. Don't worry, we're here to help. In this video, we'll show you some of the best CPUs to buy for different budgets and needs. We'll compare them in gaming, multi-threading, and editing workloads using real-world benchmarks to show you how they stack up. Before we begin, a few disclaimers. We won't be looking at power consumption or efficiency in this video, as that's a whole different topic. We'll cover that in a separate video. We also won't include the cost of the motherboards or RAM in our value calculations, as those can vary depending on your preferences. We'll focus on the CPUs themselves and how they perform. And starting us off with high-end gaming, we compare the averages in 12 games at max settings with an RTX 4090, such as Spider-Man, Mountain Blade 2, God of War, Forza Horizon 5, Far Cry 6, Elden Ring, Doom Eternal, Cyberpunk 2077, CSGO, Borderlands 3, Battlefield 5, and The Age of Empires 4. And starting us off in 1080p, the recently released 7800X3D is a clear winner, beating the 1300K by 4%, and even the much more expensive 7950X3D by 6%, helping to highlight how much of a fraud the 7950X3D is, a CPU that costs $250 more than the 7800X3D, at least in gaming. The best value gaming CPU for 1080p appears to be the 13700K, which gives 4% more value than the 7800X3D in terms of performance per dollar. Moving along to 1440p, the 7800X3D again outperforms the pack, beating the 7950X3D this time by 5% and the 1300K by 2%. So again, the 7800X3D still takes the lead overall for gaming. Onto the value for 1440p, and the 13700K is still the best value, overtaking the 7800X3D in performance per dollar by 7%. Now at 4K, with the 1300K, the performance versus the 7800X3D is identical, so I'll still call it a win for the 7800X3D, but for value, the 13700K still proves to be a fierce contender for overall performance per dollar. There is not much of a difference overall between these chips. However, this is because we are becoming GPU limited at 4K. So summing all that up, the 7800X3D is overall the best gaming processor, going as far as to beat the 1300K at 1080 and 1440p, while on the other hand for value, the 13700K is still the king. Onto the mid-range comparisons now, which is what most of you at home care about. At 1080p, the 7700X manages to be the most powerful out of all the CPUs, though by not much, beating the 13600K in average FPS in all 12 games by an insignificant 0.3%. But for value, once again, at 1080p, the 7600X manages to be the most cost-effective, supplying 26% more value compared to its closest competitor, the 13600K. Over to 1440p, the tables turn as the 13600K proves to be the most powerful out of the lot, beating the 7700X in average frames by 2%, while for value at 1440p, the 7600X still manages to be the most cost-effective out of the lot, supplying 24% more performance per dollar versus the 13600K at this resolution. Finally, at 4K, the 13600K is the winner once again, making it the winner overall. But what we saw with the higher-end CPUs does not change here, as the overall difference between all these CPUs is exceedingly small as we are becoming GPU limited. However, for value, the last generation 12600K manages to supply the most performance per dollar, but only merely, as again, we are GPU limited here, so whatever is the cheapest would obviously provide the most value. Overall, for the mid-range CPUs, the best for gaming would be the 13600K, with the best value CPU for this segment being the 7600X. Moving on to the high-end for editing and content creation, which includes Photoshop, Premiere, After Effects, Lightroom, and DaVinci Resolve, comparing the overall average scores in PugetBench for all these applications, makes it clear that the 13900K is the best of the best here, most probably due to its UHD 770i GPU, which includes Intel's QuickSync, speeding up its encoding performance. It performs 8% better on average than the 7950X, with the 13700K being close behind. However, as we get into average performance per dollar, the 13700K ends up being the most price-effective CPU by a long shot, making the 7950X look like a terrible value in comparison, which means that the 13700K is the overall winner for value, with the 13900K being the best overall winner. Now, there is the 13900KS, but the difference between it and the non-special edition is exceedingly small, and it's not worth the much higher price tag. On to mid-range now, and the 13600K is the winner winner here, beating even the 7700X by 9%, and additionally beating the last generation 12700K by 5%, again in content creation. Moving over to value, the last generation 12600K represents the best value here, supplying decent performance at a $240 price tag, and even outperforming the 7600X by 3%. So to sum it all up, the 13600K is the overall winner, with the 12600K being the best overall value. Next up is the multi-threading performance, which covers any applications such as Blender and CPU 3D rendering, or any applications that are AVX instruction heavy, such as again Blender, but specifically the Cycles renderer. The benchmarks shown include the average results for V-Ray, Cinebench R23 multi-threaded, and Blender. And for the high end, the 7950X takes the cake, beating the 1300K by 9% and taking the crown for the best consumer multi-threading CPU, but not by much. However, this does not extend to its value, with the 13700K once again taking the lead as the most cost-effective out of all the high-end CPUs, beating the 7950X in value by 19%. So to sum it all up, the 7950X is the best overall multi-threading CPU, with the 13700K once again being the best overall value. Moving over to the mid-range multi-threading performance, much like what we saw in content creation, the 13600K amazingly performs the best out of all of it, beating the last generation i7-12700K by 5%, and also beating the 7700X by 27%. So it's safe to say that the 13600K is the best CPU for multi-threading in the mid-range. However, in terms of value, once again the 12600K proves to be the best performance per dollar, providing 2% more performance per dollar than the 13600K. However, the 13600K still gives pretty good performance per dollar here as well, so I would be hard-pressed not to say it is an excellent value either. So to sum it up, the 13600K performs the best overall in this price range, while the 12600K still offers the best value, like what we saw in content creation. But anyway, that's all for today. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Also make sure to check out some of our other GPU reviews.